Adding chat to YouTube stream. So I've seen a lot of tutorials on how to add Twitch chat to the stream, but for YouTube, I really struggled to find answers. So that is why I decided to make this video. There will be three ways that I will be talking about. First is basic. It's not beautiful, but it's reliable. The second is using free CSS or paid CSS, or if you know how to code your own stuff, you can include that as well. And lastly is using streamElements. As far as level, I will call this tutorial an intermediate level. I am assuming you at least have added your mic and video source to OBS. If not, I recommend checking out an intro to OBS to get you situated. I will provide a link below. Now, some of the resources I'll be using for today is going to be OBS, Google, and streamElements. I will not be using Streamlab OBS, also known as slobs, because I have no personal experience, and then also rumor has it that it's bloatware. To start, open up OBS. So first, you create a web browser source in OBS over here. Now, you can name it whatever you want. I'm just going to call it basic chat here for now. Click OK, and we're going to have to go to YouTube to grab the URL. If you've never been live before, it will probably look a little bit different, so you might have to set that up. But once you got it, go to stream. Because the chat URL changes, I go to live stream right here to test it. And just for extra security, I make sure that it is unlisted so no one gets an unnecessary alert if for some reason I decide to go live. Find the chat, pop it out, and then copy the URL. You will have to add the URL every time you stream because each stream you do afterwards has its own unique chat address. So that is the most annoying part for me personally. Hold Alt to cut the parts out. Now this chat is looking a little bit long, so I'm gonna go and change the width and height. I messed up. I'm gonna have to drag this out. I think this happened because I hit Alt. Let me just flip vertically. And there we go. See, that looks a little bit better. And then we cut that part out. And I think this looks good if your color scheme is black, yellow, red. But since mine is more pastel color, I'm not a huge fan of how this looks personally. As far as I know, you can't make it transparent, but you can mess around with blend modes and filters to kind of make it prettier. Subtract kind of works, but then it like messes with how your emotes look as well. And there you have it. So up next is the CSS code. You can grab a free code here over at Chat V2. Some folks also have a free version on Ko-fi or other shops where you can download digital assets. And there's a bunch of options on how to customize it. Just turning it blue right now. You can mess around with this as much as you want. You can even change the font. Now, once you're done, you can copy the CSS code here. And what I did was I just hit Control A and that selected everything. And then I just go to copy. And I'm going to call this Chat V2. And we are going to put what we just copied down into the custom CSS. And don't forget to add your custom URL to your chat as well, as we did in the previous version. And this is what I have. It has the same issues of it being a strange size. You can go back and make it a different size in the height and width. And this is how the one that I purchased looks like. I made it so it's pink when I talk. There was an option to upload your custom emotes to make it a little bit more high res. What I do sometimes is during the starting soon screen, I just hide the chat, I go in and add the new URL, and then we're good to go. But if you schedule streams, you can also get your chat URL ahead of time, and then you don't have to do what I do and do it as you go. The cons of the CSS version is that YouTube sometimes makes updates that somehow disable the CSS code ability. This happened this August 2024, most recently. The most I could do was use the second method or the first. and wait for OBS to add the fix. Luckily, they fixed it in like a day or two with an update, so be sure to keep your OBS updated as well as the new versions roll out. Using streamElements, I just googled it. This page should show up, should look like this, and hit YouTube. Sign into your YouTube channel. streamElements does have a plugin, but I personally do not like it. It overrides things in OBS, and apparently it can be a more unstable version. OBS is great, it's open source, it has quick updates, it's reliable, also it's free. And then once we're in, we can go to my overlays. I just realized I'm in my Twitch one, so be sure that you are in the correct one for YouTube. And hit new overlay. Choose the resolution that you will be streaming in. And we will add an image. It could also be a video if your overlay loops. And this image, you don't have to add it. This is just for if you want to see where you want the chat to be on the canvas. This part is completely optional. I'm just going into MS Paint really quickly to make a square to put the chat on. Just making it pink. And then hit upload. You could either drag and drop the file or search for it. And there we go. Make it a little bit bigger. And then we're gonna add the chat. Now the chat is just a black box because it's not connected. As far as I know, streamElements only adds your chat once you're live. That's the unfortunate part about this because you can't customize it when you're not live. At least that's my experience. I'm just kind of guessing, like changing the font color, font size. Other con that I don't like about this is that it doesn't show your custom emotes. I'm gonna show an example of what it looks like. It's just text. So that's the unfortunate part. No emotes, very little customization. You can't test it if you're not live, but you don't have to change the URL every single time. So that is the perk. All right, now that I have all my settings guessed out, I'm gonna hit save. I'm gonna name it. And then if you don't plan on using this background, you can hide them in these layers. And then you'll just have the chat and you can hit copy link URL. Oh, and be sure to save again, because every time you make a change, it will have to update it by saving. All right, we're going to do the same as we did before. We're going to hit browser. I'm going to call it SE for streamElements. Paste the URL. We don't have to worry about the custom CSS. I'm going to change the width and height to the resolution. And there we go. And this did not load the background. This is just the chat itself. So if I change my mind and I think this is too small, I could just drag it. And then I can hit lock so I accidentally don't move it in the future. And that is it. My way of troubleshooting when something doesn't want to work is either to reset the cache, or in some cases I just delete the old browser source and make a brand new one. Sometimes that brings it back to life, but sometimes it could just be YouTube's problem. Which eventually gets fixed. You just have to wait it out a day or two for OBS to figure it out. I usually check Reddit, see if anybody else has had the problem, but I feel like it's good to have a backup way of having chat. The chat isn't super necessary, but I personally like to have it for archiving purposes. So that is it. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this was helpful. And don't subscribe if you expect more tutorials. I usually don't do streaming or video tutorials, but this was one that I just wanted to address because it was something I did not see talked about a lot. But yeah, thank you so much. Bye!